James 5:4. Idu. Ha misthas ton ergaton ton amesanton tas choras humon. Ha apostere minas af humon kradze. Kai hai boai ton theresanton esta ota kuriu sabaoth es eleluthasen. Translation. Behold, the pay of your workers who mowed or who reaped the fields of you, who reaped your fields, which was held back in fraud by you, cries out. And the cries of the harvesters have entered in to the ears of the Lord of hosts. Okay, let's begin with this last statement here, the Lord of hosts. That Sabaoth, that is just a transliteration of the Hebrew, Sabaoth, right? Transliteration is where you write a word from one language in the letters of another. So it's not translating it, it's transliterating it. And it's translated Lord of Hosts, or I think the New Living Translation says the Lord of Heaven's Armies. So while these poor workers are being defrauded, James is encouraging them, you have the Lord of Heaven's Armies, Almighty God, and all of His angelic host on your side. A word of great encouragement to those who are suffering in this way. Let's look at this little word, idu, at the beginning. Again, that's a frozen imperative. We've seen a few of those, and I'm just, for pedagogical purposes, repeating this to try to drive this home, right? It's a form, technically, it's an imperative. You can see how it's from the verb harao, believe it or not. Building off the second aorist form, adon. If we do an imperative of that, we would take off the augment. We'd be left with the stem id. And then that u, that's just a second person middle imperative ending, right? This is, if we parse it out completely, this would be an aorist middle imperative, second person singular, right? Second person singular. And, of course, there's a plural. This is a plural group that's being addressed. Why would you use a second singular imperative? Well, it's a frozen imperative. It's just become a particle that is a forward-pointing particle, a forward-pointing little word that's drawing attention to what's coming.